Welcome to Old Guys on Bikes, OGOB. OGOB presents Corraglen Lap 1. That's right, you're going to be treated to all three laps of Corraglen, but this is the first one. And here we are behind one-eyed Yamaha guy, just through the starting gates, and lovely rolling hills here. And a little slippery on lap 1. And behind Yamaha guy here, and we have the Kawasaki kid in front of him. Yep, the little fella's upgraded to a 250 and it's green. So Yamaha guy getting a little bit of air over there as we make our way up a bit of a sticky clay, slippery clay track here just to start off with. Just the morning drizzle and rain overnight's made it a little tricky for some, but as you can see, the 450's just plough up there, and as the 250. But it kept us all honest for the first lap anyway, and the other subsequent laps it was okay. There we have KTM 250 guy trying the mud route alternative down there, and what's holding everybody up is pretty much the marshals and their fluorescent tops. There's a pipe there, and some people are getting stuck on that, and it doesn't help when someone gets off their bike to try and go over it. So I'm going to take this mud route that KTM 250 guy took down in there. Quite surprisingly, quite a bit of grip in the bottom of the mud, and there we go, up and out of it. Had Suzuki 250 guy with us, that's right, Adam, and this is about the only footage we have of him, because he sort of went a little bit wayward after this, so I decided to put all of this in, because apart from some real long distance stuff, trying to watch him go through that mud that we just went through, there's nothing of him in the footage. So follow him up here. This is still within the first one or two k's of the ride, and he's getting along great pace. His bike was giving him some grief. The yellow bike just didn't want to stay running, and he stalls it again up through the gates here. He says he's okay, but that is the last we saw of him until he appeared back at the cars sometime later. Back in behind the Kawasaki kid, and he gets a little bit of air over there, trying out the suspension on the bigger bike. And he's going okay, he's keeping pace with us, which is good. Changed his riding style. He doesn't stand up as much, I've noticed, and just pulls off and lets me come through. That was a cunning plan on his part, because I came down here far too fast, and there's a drop off here which was quite nasty when you didn't know about it, and that bottomed out my front forks and gave us a bit of a fright. Back in behind Yamaha guy here. And again, just the first lap, things are a little bit slippery, and we just come down in this creek bed, nothing too difficult at all. Across there, just a bit slippery out the other side, but nothing a handful of throttle won't fix, and then we're off again. Awesome ride this Corraglen, first time we've done it, and certainly be coming back to it. It's well organized, well marked out, and just really enjoyable rolling hills. The odd little bridge there and a bit of clay would have been a different story if it had rained. I think some of the tracks and hills would have been a lot more tricky than they were, but put it this way, the first lap sort of boys out from the men in that respect, but as the day rode on, it certainly got a lot more tacky and had a lot more grip there. So just past Yamaha guy and back in behind Kawasaki kid. I'm just going to cut a corner here and get past him and go and see what one-eyed Yamaha guy is up to. There we go. And didn't see much of him because we're back in behind the Yamaha guy here at the top of the hill. And it was pretty much that hill that we're just on the top of the hill climb up there, which was causing some difficulties for some on the first lap. After that, it was all really good. So I've done some spraying of the gorse through here. Plenty of dead gorse. There's a bit of green stuff there. That one around here. And nice. And there were some other options you could take. A bit of a hill. Little hill climb there and tag back in behind one-eyed Yamaha guy. And surprise, surprise, who do we find? It's KTM 250 guy. There we go. And that's about the last time you see him as well. Went up there. And surprisingly enough, on lap 3, I actually broke my rear subframe just coming up over that bump there. Turns out I had a bolt missing. That's a completely different story. Out past Kawasaki Kid, as this hill just keeps on going and going. And then once you get to the top, you hit a clay track. And some of us don't get to the top. But these two just keep spraying shit everywhere. Look at it all flying there. Mainly coming off Yamaha guy's rear wheel. Back behind Kawasaki Kid after he caught up after that hill. And he's getting along good pace. And he's back to his usual riding style, standing up. Like father, like son. And daughter when she eventually turns up to her ride. And there we go. Got some good pace on. So why not stick behind them? And you get a little bit of air as we drop off here, or it tries, not a lot. And then back in behind one-eyed Yamaha guy. He's all about trying to get that back wheel to step out. And it steps out too much there for him. Nothing the wind of the throttle won't fix. And coming to near the end now. Last little hill climb up the fence line here. Kawasaki Kid didn't fare too well coming up here. He got stuck about this point, but I decided to leave it out because it wasn't fair. It was quite tricky. So, produced by OGOB, narrated by Honda Guy, music by Rage Against the Machine. Make sure you come back and check out lap 2. Remember, first gear in the pits.